Hi guys, and welcome to My name is Rolson, and in this video I'll tell you why the so-called Guardians of Destiny 2 are the absolute worst villains in the entire universe. I've been playing Destiny 2 for some time now, diving deep into all of the content and the lore, and today while walking to work, I came to a terrible realization. I know that you, as well as I, probably feel that you're doing so much good defending the last city against the enemies of humanity, battling the darkness and fighting for the light. It all sounds very heroic, but what if, hold on to your spinfall hat guys, what if the Guardians of Destiny are actually the soldiers of a totalitarian regime annihilating everything and everyone in their way? What if, my friends, we are indeed the villains of the universe? This might sound very strange to you, but follow along my logic here and see if any of this rings true to you, or if I'm just a dim-witted box of rocks that could have spent my time a lot better than spending 10 hours making this video. Let's see. So the catalyst for this realization was actually another game entirely. I've just played through The Last of Us Part 2, and in this game the story plays a lot on the duality of moral. That the morally correct thing for one person can be a horrible act of evil in the eyes of another person. So on my way to work I was thinking to myself, what if I put myself in the shoes of the enemies in Destiny? How would I look at the Guardians then? I quickly realized that, oh my god, what have we done? Let's take a look at us. The Guardians, the righteous warriors of the light. Our mission is to protect the last city, and as stated in the very intro of the game by our ghost, to reclaim our lost worlds. So this seems pretty noble, right? We're defending humanity and reclaiming our lost territory. What could be wrong with that? Well, nothing if you're of the belief that humanity is the single race in the entire universe that deserves to be saved and that deserves to expand. And if we're being totally honest, is humanity really that great? Like, we murder and kill each other on a regular basis, we exploit every resource that we come into contact with, we move to an area, then consume resources until there's nothing left, and then we move on. We discriminate, undermine, enslave, and most of the time we do this in the name of realizing our selfish desires, like having flashy things or being more comfortable. And also, we know very, very little about what the humanity in the Destiny universe has actually been up to. Like, these lost worlds that we need to reclaim, how did they become ours? Were they just free for the taking, or was there conflict involved? Did we eradicate some native species when we took these worlds in the first place? I know the assumption is that these worlds were dead planets before the Traveler came to them, but we don't know that. That is what we are told through the lore, but who are the writers of these lore books? Are they the very people that have committed horrible acts to expand the human race? We just don't know. Like, are we really the ultimate pinnacle of evolution in this universe? Because if we're not, then what gives us the right to just slaughter everyone we meet in the name of humanity's prosperity? And now you might be thinking, but Rolson, we only defend ourselves. But is that actually true? Hasn't there been times where we were the attackers? There certainly have. Let's just talk about the Ahamkara for a minute here, because seriously, we need to talk about this. The Ahamkara is an ancient race of creatures that have wish-granting abilities. They have played an integral role in the story of the Destiny universe, helping build the Dreaming City, and then also being part in its destruction is just one very important part they have played. From the lore books, we know that the Ahamkara were known to the Guardians during the City Age, and many Guardians made bargains with the creatures in order to reach greater power and fulfill other desires. It was ultimately decided that the prices of these bargains were too great, and the Vanguard ordered that the Ahamkara be exterminated in an event that became known as the Great Ahamkara Hunt. Wait! What? So the Guardians used these creatures for their own good, and when they got tired of playing with them, they were like, we're just going to exterminate the entire race from the universe. Hey, let's have some fun with it. Let's call it the Great Hunt. We'll make a whole thing out of it. I'll bring the cake, Zavala makes special bounties, Marisov will bring over extra weapons to blow the shit out of these freaking worthless creatures. The one that slaughters the most of these pests get an exotic shell called the Mayhem Kara. It's gonna be a blast. What the fuck, man? So the Ahamkara had no right to live? What, they didn't deserve proper trial or just be left alone after the Guardians were done having their way with them? They were just deemed useless by the Vanguard, and that meant that they all had to be annihilated? What? According to the lore, the Vanguard deemed them too dangerous to be allowed to live. Like, what type of self-righteous, narcissistic, inhumane kind of organization would you have to be to make a call like that? And this is not even the only example. Remember that strike where you fight the Scion Karkin, the technocrat? Well, if you remember the dialogue, you kind of just stumble upon him and Zavala makes a quick decision that you should just take him out. Just listen to this.
Cabal Scion, he's caused significant damage to the Vex Collective in this time stream.
This sounds bad.
Gun, I'm making the elimination of Karkin more priority on this approach. His crew has been active all over the system. From our intel, he's mostly targeting Vex installations. However, removing him can only strengthen our position. Put him down.
So basically, Zavala says that even though they don't know what he's doing and that he's only targeting Vex installations, you should just take him out, you know, just to be sure. This is just the same kind of logic behind the extermination of the Aokara. We don't know what to do with him, let's just kill him. Are you starting to get the picture? Like, what exactly are we carrying out when taking orders from the Vanguard? These are just two small examples, but there are loads of instances where the Vanguard basically just eradicate some enemy because, well, because they're the enemy, right? We're the supreme race and all the other subpar races are just scum that should be exterminated, right? Listen, if you really think about it, are these enemies so evil? I'm sure they don't think so. They have the reasons for attacking us. The Hive have the religion, the sword logic, and they need to feed their worm gods. Is that evil? Well, it's not if you look at it completely from their perspective. They're fulfilling what they believe to be the meaning of life. The Hive believe in the sword logic. They don't operate with the terms good and evil. They instead see strong or weak, strong being good, and weak being bad. They seek to eradicate the universe of everything weak so that only the strong is left. In their view, this is the equivalent of eradicating all evil from the world. But because this does not match up with our perception of good and evil, we think that murdering the entire family of the Hive Dynasty is just crack and dandy. What about the Fallen? They're basically trying to take back the Traveler because they used to have it and used to enjoy all of the benefits that the Traveler is now giving to the human race. You know, like extended lifespans, advanced technology, new ecosystems to inhabit, and so on. They're just trying to make their people thrive again so they can build a society and live fulfilling lives. The lives that was promised to them by the Traveler, but then suddenly taken away because the Traveler got bored and decided to move on. That sounds real evil, huh? Well, what do you think we would do if the Traveler left us? Based on history, we would probably set out on a crusade to obliterate every living thing that just looks like our way. But apparently the human race just deserves the Traveler more than the Fallen and anyone else because, as we have established, humans are the supreme race and our lives just matter more than the other races. Jesus! Like, am I the only one seeing this? And this is not even all of it. There's more. The Guardians are scary as hell. Listen, the Guardians are undead. In case you forgot, we're warriors risen from the dead by the Traveler, at which time the Traveler chose to conveniently erase our memories and give us this little brainwashing machine floating right by our ear at all times, constantly telling us what to do and what to think. Think about it. Since you woke from the dead, you have just been following the advice of your ghost that is supposed to speak for the Traveler. And now that we're on the topic of speaking to the Traveler, let's just talk about the speaker for a little bit. Yeah, you know, the guy that basically told everyone what the Traveler was saying, the closest thing that the Last City has to a spiritual leader. You remember how at the end of the Destiny 2 campaign it was revealed that the Traveler never actually spoke to him, that he basically made it all up? Yeah, so the prophecies and the philosophy and basically the entire spiritual foundation of the Last City was all based on a lie. Let's just sum all of this up before we continue. So, the Guardians are basically zombie warriors which have been granted superpowers and are under constant mind control by the Traveler through the Ghost, viewing themselves as a supreme being in the universe worthy of allocating life and death as they please, following a now dead liar of a spiritual leader that took advantage of his powerful position to spread his own philosophy as if it came directly from the Traveler. Yep, we are truly some commendable dudes and dudettes. Whenever we get a chance to pocket some more power, we take it. If it means using darkness, screw it. As long as it makes us excel at wasting other races, we're willing to do literally anything. Being guinea pigs for the Drifter and the Nine, mindlessly killing enemies, collecting canned darkness and storing it securely for them. No problem, just use me up just a little bit more. Just give me a little bit more, a little bit more light, just a little bit. Come on, man, I'll do anything. Can you hear it?
Sorry, bro, I'm all out, man.
Man, I got these cheeseburgers, man.
I don't want any cheeseburgers.
Please, man. I suck your dick.
Ew. Get out of here, man.
The Guardians are power junkies. The latest exotic we got lets us turn enemies into orbs of energy that we can then slam into the face of other foes. Like, just imagine. Just imagine, guys, you're chilling with your hive buddies, just dishing out some sword logic, doing some good in the universe, you know, and out of the blue comes this maniac, this freaking psycho of a brainwashed zombie warrior and points this ray of pure darkness at your best homie. Your friend looks at you, you lock eyes for a short second, you see the pure terror in his eyes, he screams, he reaches for you, with his last breath he whispers, "Tell Asmuroth, the breathing darkness and the children that I love them," before he's turned into a small orb of light. You look terrified at the guardian who is now flying through the air towards you. You frantically start shooting and running sideways to get further away from this monster you just encountered. The guardian now lands, picks up the orb, runs towards you, jumps high into the air above you, and slams the orb straight down onto the top of your head. Everything is black. Your soul leaves your body. On the way, you see the guardian teabagging your corpse, followed by some breathtaking dance moves. This is the absolute mental train wreck that is the guardian in Destiny 2. But as long as it makes us feel more powerful, we don't mind the fact that the weapon was gifted to us by the darkness. No problem. Kind of reminds me of the Vietnam War, right? We're the heroin addicted soldiers carrying out horrific acts because reasons. The only difference is that we can't quit. We can't die. Our little fascist mind control robot denies us the sweet peace of death. No, no, wake up, Guardian. It's time to carry out some more violent abolishment. There are still living things in the universe to massacre. We're essentially playing as an undead junkie mercenary hired by a totalitarian fascist regime hellbent on wiping out everyone that does not share their philosophy, formulated by a pathological liar pretending to be the voice of some godly floating orb that we know absolutely nothing about. The Guardians of Destiny 2, my friends, are the worst. The absolute freaking worst. But you know what? Screw it. Let's go teabag some ugly ass hive and dance on their corpses. Let's be bad. Let's embrace our true dark nature. My friends, let's go beyond light. If you want to connect with me or other gaming watchers, feel free to join the Discord. There's a link in the description. If you like this video, please make sure to leave a like and consider subscribing to the channel. And if you don't want to miss out on any Destiny videos or news, hit that notification bell. As always, guys, thank you so much for watching, and I'll see you in the next video.